Today, the government in Delhi is under the impression that they can destroy the cultures of this country. They believe that they can suppress the emotions of the Tamil people. They believe they can crush the language of the Tamil people. They believe that they can suppress the spirit of the Tamil people. I came to give them a message that nobody is going to suppress the Tamil spirit.
The Modi government's One Nation, One Culture policy has exposed their intolerance and anti-secular mindset, and time and again, the BJP has hurt Tamil sentiments. While the BJP continued to push Hindi as the one language of India since it came to power in 2014, it got out of hand once the BJP started arresting and threatening several Tamil orators, artists, writers, and even journalists to adopt the Hindi language. Exemption for NEET and the new education policy that proposes a three-language formula to facilitate a backdoor entry to Hindi are just a few other anti-Tamil BJP policies. That's not all. The state of Tamil Nadu has been left to borrow from many sources to pay for salaries and pensions, spend on healthcare and welfare departments, and prevent the spread of COVID-19. The ruling government's anti-Tamil Nadu policies and ideologies ensured that PM Modi faced maximum protests in Tamil Nadu, both on social media and on the ground. Because contrary to the PM's belief, only Tamils will decide the future of Tamil Nadu.
He does not understand that only the Tamil people can decide on the future of Tamil Nadu.